subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is known around the world for its history, cultural heritage and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving the way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay and today in an episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Gurudwaras across India lit up in festive spirit as Sikhs observed the most auspicious occasion of Guru Nanak Jayanti, the birth anniversary of the founder of Sikhism. The festival was celebrated with immense zeal and enthusiasm by the devotees following the COVID-19 SOPs. Have a look.
Sri Harmandir Sahib or Golden Temple, situated in Amritsar city of Punjab, dazzled with colourful lights as it marked the 551st birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev, the founder of Sikhism. Though the number of devotees was quite less as compared to previous years due to the pandemic, but the enthusiasm was the same. Following the social distancing norms, devotees took holy dips, lit candles and offered prayers early in the day to mark the birth anniversary.
ਇਹ ਸਾਡੇ ਫਸਟ ਪਹਿਲੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਦਾ ਗੁਰਪੁਰਬ ਹੈ ਜੀ ਜਨਮਦਿਨ ਅਤੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਸੰਗਤਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੁਮਹਮ ਆ ਕੇ ਪਹੁੰਚੀਆਂ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਨੇ ਅਤੇ ਇੱਥੇ ਦੀਪਮਾਲਾ ਵੀ ਸਵੇਰੇ ਸਵੇਰੇ ਜਗਾ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਦੀ ਖੁਸ਼ੀਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪ੍ਰਾਪਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਨੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਸੰਗਤ ਇਸ਼ਨਾਨ ਕਰ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ
Meanwhile, in capital New Delhi, Sri Bangla Sahib Gurdwara was beautifully decorated to commemorate the occasion. Devotees wearing masks thronged the Gurdwara to pay their homage to Guru Nanak Dev. The authorities properly looked after all the arrangements and even kept on advising people to maintain distance.
आप बंगला साहब में देख सकते हैं हमने टनल बना रखी है जिसके अंदर से ही सबको गुजर के आना पड़ता है आगे जगह जगह पर सैनिटाइजर मशीनें लगाई हैं और सोशल डिस्टेंस के लिए हम बार बार लाइव बोलते हैं कि आप सब ऐसा जतन करो जिससे हम इस बीमारी से अपने आप को बचाएं दूसरों को बचाएं
Born in 1469 at Nankana Sahib, now in Pakistan, Guru Nanak Dev was the first of the 10 Sikh Gurus. He is said to have travelled far and wide across Asia, teaching people the message of Ek Omkar, meaning one God, who dwells in every one of his creation and constitutes the eternal truth. Nanak's teachings can be found in the Sikh scripture Guru Granth Sahib, as a collection of verses recorded in Gurumukhi. Every year, to celebrate this occasion, a delegation of Sikh pilgrims from India goes to Pakistan to visit Nankana Sahib ahead of his birth anniversary as it is the most important religious site for the Sikh religion. But this time, in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic, the visas for only 325 pilgrims were approved by Pakistan. Moreover, it was the first of its kind international trip for pilgrims since the outbreak of the highly contagious virus.
इस बार कोरोना महामारी कारण सिर्फ ननकाना साहब की यात्रा ले ही परमिशन मिली है पर संगत की बहुत इच्छा सी भी पंजा साहब जाते सच्चा सौदा देखते असी श्री करतारपुर साहब जाते
Sikhism was founded in the 15th century in Punjab, an area straddling the border between Pakistan and India, by Guru Nanak and has had 10 successive gurus.
The mystical form of Islam has entrenched itself at the center of cultural and spiritual life in India. Serving as the richest reservoir of Sufism is the state of Jammu and Kashmir that has tombs of Sufi saints located in almost all of its villages. Visited by people from different communities, these tombs characterize a unique form of devotional culture in Kashmir within the bosom of Islam. So, giving you a glimpse of this beautiful culture, today we take you to the tomb of Dastgir Sahib in Srinagar that was recently thronged by people of all faiths to commemorate the urs of Sufi saint.
The 200-year-old shrine of Hazrat Sheikh Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani, located in the Khanyar area of Srinagar, wore a festive look as devotees observed the annual urs of the 11th century Sufi saint. Popularly known as Pir Dastagir Sahib, the saint is highly revered by the locals, even though he never visited Kashmir and his actual shrine is at Baghdad in Iraq. Every year on the 11th day of Rabiul Thani, the fourth month of Islamic Hijri calendar, Kashmiris commemorate his urs, during which they offer special prayers to the saint and take part in salutations, supplications and sermons followed by the night-long prayers. This year too, a large number of devotees visited his shrine, braving the chilly weather conditions and sought for the saint's blessing to get rid of this pandemic situation.
हम यही दुआ करते हैं अल्लाह पाक से इस दसगीर दुजहान की मदद से सब जो है अमन अमान यहाँ पे कायम हो और खासकर जो ये बीमारी है अल्लाह पाक जल्द इस बीमारी को इस रियासत से रुखसत फरमाए
With its eclectic emphasis on tolerance and peaceful coexistence, Sufism has been guiding the life of Kashmiris for nearly 700 years. Even today, the teachings of Sufi saints reverberate in every nook and corner of the valley and continue to inspire people to live in harmony. People visit their dargahs as they serve as an abode of peace and tranquility and help them experience mental and spiritual peace.
आज के मादी दौर में इंसान ये मुख्तलिफ मामलात में फंसा हुआ है इसलिए इंसान को वो सुकून हासिल नहीं होता है दुनिया में वो इन्हीं दरगाहों में सुकून क्लब हासिल करने के लिए आते हैं चूँकि इस वक्त मुबारक ये जो उर्स मुबारक इस वक्त चल रहा है बहुत सारे लोग और हम इस वक्त मुसीबत में है कोविड-19 की वजह से तो बहुत सारे लोग इस वक्त आते हैं दुआएँ मांगते हैं कि यहाँ कश्मीर में हालात और ये जो कोविड-19 जो हमें एक आफत की वजह से हम इस वक्त फंसे हुए हैं यहाँ आहुजारी करते हैं इस इन दरगाहों पे और अल्लाह से ये दुआ मांगते हैं कि हर वक्त ये जो मुसीबतें नाजिल होती है इस वक्त ये इस कश्मीर में वो दूर हो जाए
As a part of the Urs celebration of Dastagir Sahib, Sufi scholars and religious preachers threw light on the life, religious services, teachings and spiritual strength of the saint who devoted his entire life to spread love and brotherhood. The holy celebration clearly indicates that the lesson of humanity and compassion that was once propagated by the Sufi saint is still having its roots deeply embedded in the culture of Kashmir Valley.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A cultural event was held in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir to lift the spirits of people fighting coronavirus pandemic and subsequent lockdowns amid a harsh winter. Artists in traditional attires came in from across the Kashmir Valley and took part in the Jashne Chilai Kalan cultural program organized by the Culture Ministry.
आज के ज़माने में बेहद ज़रूरत थी, खासकर कश्मीर में सर्दियां हैं और लॉकडाउन में आपको पता है कोविड की वजह से आर्टिस्ट को बहुत कम प्लेटफॉर्म मिलता है, ज़्यादातर ऑनलाइन होता है। तो एक उम्मीद सी जगी है, हमारे जो फनकार हैं सब इसमें पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं और एक जो उनका रोज़गार भी है इससे चलता है।
The Kashmir Valley is a popular destination among tourists from across the world who are drawn to its Himalayan summits and treks along with picturesque valleys and lakes.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi recently attended Dev Deepavali, the Valley of the Deities in Varanasi city of Uttar Pradesh. Dev Deepavali is celebrated on the 15th day after Diwali, the festival of lights. It is celebrated on the full moon day in the Kartik month of Hindu calendar as a tribute to the river Ganges by Hindu devotees. The steps of the banks of the river Ganges sparkled with more than 100,000 earthen lamps lit to honor the Ganges, which is considered a mother and goddess in Hinduism. Elaborated cultural programs were also held at the festivities.
आज माँ गंगा के सानिध्य में काशी प्रकाश का उत्सव मना रही है और मुझे भी महादेव के आशीर्वाद से इस प्रकाश गंगा में डुबकी लगाने का सौभाग्य मिल रहा है।
The celebrations in Varanasi, where priests offer prayer holding huge butter lamps, is a major tourist attraction. Dev Deepavali also marks the end of the fortnight of Diwali celebrations, and a major event on the day is the lighting of earthen lamps in the night after the moon is sighted.
A student from Ayurvedic College in Puri city of Odisha has started an awareness campaign among people regarding COVID-19 precautions, along with distributing immunity development doses prepared from herbal ingredient quat, which is also recommended by Ayush Ministry. Akshay Kumar Nayak, who has made these doses, said that he collected the herbs from his own herbal garden and some from the local market and prepared it on his own as per the guidelines of Ayush Department. As the COVID-19 vaccine is under trial, it may take months to be finally available in the market. In this time gap, the virus can mutate the RNA or ribonucleic acid of human body, after which even the vaccine will not be effective. So, the only way left is to improve the body's immunity.
Indian trendsetters can now protect against the coronavirus, especially during the ongoing wedding season, in stylish masks adorned with pearls and intricate embroideries. Designers in Surat city of Gujarat are focusing on both providing their customers with good quality masks to prevent the virus and spreading cheer despite the gloom that the disease has brought to the wedding season.
फैब्रिक हमारा खुद का है, हमने उस पर एंटी माइक्रोबियल एंटी बैक्टीरियल प्रॉपर्टीज से ट्रीट किया है ताकि कोई भी जर्म्स भी आए तो भी मर जाए। हमने ऑस्ट्रेलिया से केमिकल इंपोर्ट किया कि कोविड के वायरस भी, उसके सर्टिफिकेशंस भी हमारे पास, कोविड के वायरस भी उसके साथ आए तो वो भी उससे किल हो जाए।
मास्क दैट हैव आल्सो बिकम अ स्टाइल स्टेटमेंट विद डिफरेंट कलर्स एंड हंड्रेड्स ऑफ वैरायटीज आर बीइंग डिजाइंड एज पर वेडिंग थीम्स, keeping in mind the customers' demands to add some fun to the wedding season.
As the Indian government is busy battling coronavirus outbreak, a number of citizens and organizations too are not behind in extending their support to the needy people who are worst affected by this pandemic. Be it through distributing essential items, study material or oxygen cylinders, people have been contributing their bit without making any discrimination on the basis of caste and community. One such example can be found in the Amritsar city of Punjab, where a voluntary organization is helping the needy people to survive this tough time of pandemic. Have a look.
At this need of the hour, when the whole country is battling against the pandemic, a number of individuals and organizations have come to the forefront to help the needy, irrespective of their caste and community. Ma Durga Welfare Society Jai Ho Club in Amritsar city of Punjab is one among them. Serving people for the last 11 years, this voluntary organization has proved to be of great help to the city people amid the pandemic. As a part of their recent initiative, the NGO distributed supplements among the needy children to help them strengthen their immunity and grow both physically as well as mentally.
इस लॉकडाउन में 6 महीने लगातार 6 महीने से सेवा कर रहे हैं, जिसमें हमने 25,000 के करीब परिवारों को राशन बांटा, उसके साथ साथ उनको गैस सिलेंडर और भी घर की जो जरूरी सुविधाएं हैं, खाने का राशन, दाल वगैरह और कपड़े, दूध उनको मुहैया करवाया। उसके साथ साथ हमने सारे शहर को सैनिटाइज किया, जिसमें वॉल सिटी, सरकारी ऑफिस, पुलिस स्टेशन, और हमने जब स्कूल शुरू हुए तो हम स्कूलों को भी सैनिटाइज करने की मुहिम शुरू की है।
As the volunteers distributed a packet of brain boosters, the children quietly stood in a queue and collected the packet one by one. They were also given free masks and asked to maintain proper social distancing. Locals lauded the efforts of the organization that has been constantly serving the society.
आज हमने बच्चों को इम्यूनिटी सिस्टम स्ट्रांग करने के लिए जो हम पिछले 4 महीनों से लगातार बांट रहे हैं, हमने ब्रेन बूस्टर बांटे हैं बच्चों को, ताकि इनका इम्यूनिटी सिस्टम जो स्ट्रांग किया जाए। उसके साथ साथ जो लॉकडाउन में जिन परिवारों का रोजी रोटी छिन गई थी, जो कमा नहीं सकते, उन परिवारों को हमने आइडेंटिफाई करके अपनी एनजीओ की ओर से उनको राशन भी दिया।
ये जय हो क्लब वाले हैगे ने ते बहुत बच्चिया काम कर रहे, इन्होंने काफ़ी कुछ बच्चों को दिता होया है। इन्होंने लॉकडाउन में बहुत पब्लिक की सेवा की हुई है इन्होंने, तो परमात्मा ने बहुत ज़्यादा तवे अगे भी गांह तरक्की कर, बहुत ज़्यादा तरक्की कर।
Apart from distributing energy supplements to children, the NGO also distributed food packets of rice, flour and other necessary stuff among the needy. They had also started a sanitization drive wherein they sanitized all the vulnerable places in Amritsar city in order to prevent the spread of the virus. The Jai Ho group has been distributing gas cylinders, ration, sanitization kits and has been carrying out other activities too to help the citizens fight the pandemic.
In times like these, when technological advancements have become an everyday affair, the tech-savvy youngsters are looking for new platforms to express themselves and showcase their talents. Recently, a new podcast series has been launched by a teenager in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, which is providing a new platform to Kashmiri youngsters to come forward and put up their views, suggestions and achievements.
It's been said that our success is directly proportional to our ability to understand, adopt and integrate new technology. With the daily advancements in technology, new online platforms are coming up with the motive of providing more exposure to teenagers so as to put out their inspiring stories in front of the world. A recent initiative is taken by a Kashmiri youngster, Umar Nisar, who has launched a podcast series to empower young talent to harness their creativity and inspire other young individuals.
हमने ये initiative start किया, ये obviously इनके लिए एक platform है. Writers आएंगे, photographers आएंगे, हर एक talent अपने अपने fields में आएगा. ऑब्वियसली उनको प्लेटफॉर्म मिलेगा. उसके बाद हाँ, और एक चीज़ है कि वे इन और वे आउट, उसमें हम इनके लिए रखा, हमने एक ऑनलाइन फंड रेजिंग भी स्टार्ट की, जिससे हम उस फंड रेजिंग से इन यूथ बेस्ड इनिशिएटिव को फंड करेंगे. बिकॉज इट्स नॉट माइन इनिशिएटिव ऑनली, इट्स ऑफ द यूथ, इट्स बाय द यूथ, इट्स फॉर द यूथ.
Named as Mashq Talks, the platform features young and talented Kashmiri youngsters whose creations and achievements have been making waves in Kashmir.
Farhana, welcome to Kashmir.
Thank you so much, Omar.
Aapki jo practical journey dekh sakte hain ya artist.
Telecasted in Kashmiri language, it is an episodic series of audio and video files that aims to connect young Kashmiris to the world via digital media. The podcast is available on all online platforms like Spotify, Google Podcasts, Facebook for Creators, Postbean, Breaker and other international platforms. Its serialized podcast titled The 100 Kashmir aims to bring out loud stories of 100 talented Kashmiri youngsters who are excelling in different fields like dancing, writing, music and many more.
मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा ये इनका कॉन्सेप्ट जो इनका है ऑनलाइन. और आजकल सबको ही पता है कि लाइक हम सारे सोशल मीडिया पे ही होते हैं, ज़्यादा एक्टिव, तो ये सोशल मीडिया पे ही ज़्यादा आने वाला है और सबके लिए बहुत ही अच्छा है. उनको कहीं से देखना नहीं है, उसके लिए बाहर नहीं जाना है, सारा सोशल मीडिया पर, और हम बहुत यूज़ करते हैं इसके लिए. बहुत अच्छा है सबके लिए, हमारे लिए अच्छा है, यूथ के लिए अच्छा है. बहुत सारी चीज़ें उनको भी सीखने को मिलेगी, हमें सीखने को मिलेंगी, बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छा.
This is the first of its kind initiative in Kashmiri language launched by a youth-based organization called Digital Media Network. The 19 years old Umar sees Mashq Talks as Kashmir's version of TED Talks.
ये एक्चुअली दो साल पहले मैं TED Talks में गया था, जो एक इंटरनेशनल सेलिब्रिटी शो है, मैं वहाँ पे गया था. बट देन आई थॉट कि जब मैं कश्मीर वापस आया, मुझे लगा कि यार हर कोई तो यहाँ पे टैलेंट ऑब्वियसली कश्मीर में बहुत अच्छा है, बट हर कोई टेड टॉक्स में तो जा नहीं सकता है, सब करते क्या है. तो मैंने कोशिश की कि मैं कश्मीर में कश्मीर को अपना टेड टॉक्स दूँ, और एक इनिशिएटिव स्टार्ट किया जिसका हमने नाम रखा मश्क टॉक्स. मश्क टॉक्स इज सेम मॉड्यूल जैसे कि टेड टॉक्स है.
It is due to such creative and innovative initiatives like these that youngsters of Kashmir are coming to the forefront and are expressing their set of stories and creative outputs.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mindia@ainin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay. and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.